In this section, we will look at the control system. Controllers are systems that accept a measured value as an input, compare it to some desired value, and then output a control signal. The control signal is connected to a valve or switching mechanism which will move the measured value toward the desired level. For instance, imagine a temperature controller with a heater regulated by a controller. Input to the controller would be a thermal detector, like an RTD or thermocouple. Suppose the controller calls for no heat, i.e. zero control variable output. With no heat added, the system would stay at a certain temperature. Call it T1. On the other hand, if the controller calls for full heat, the system will eventually stabilize at a higher temperature. Call it T4. For every intermediate control output, there is some stable temperature. Connect temperature T1 to T4 with a line that illustrates the way the system responds to heat being added. Usually, we will not know what the shape of this curve is. Suppose we want to control the temperature to a set point, indicated by the horizontal green line, labeled set point. We could design our controller so it would call for full heat if the temperature is well below the set point, no heat if it is well above the set point, and a proportionate amount in between, as indicated by the dark blue line. The darkened band shown is the proportional band. Suppose then we position the proportional band evenly about the set point temperature, since before starting, we don't know what the shape of the black line will be. The system will eventually stabilize at temperature T2, since that is the point at which the system response line intersects the controller output. Since T2 is above our set point, there is an offset, the difference between temperatures T2 and the set point. Proportional controllers are simple, but they are likely to result in an offset. Proportional integral control is the same as proportional control, except an integral adjustment gradually reduces the offset to zero. Also, since the viscosity of a liquid is decreased by the addition of heat or a solvent, the system response line slopes down with increasing control output. Since it is assumed that a viscosity PI controller output is used to either heat the liquid or add solvent, the output has an inverse relationship between the control output and the measured value, i.e. the blue control output line slopes up to the right. This illustration shows an initial setting with PI viscosity control. The black line represents the system response to either adding heat or solvent. The graph illustrates the system in its initial state with an offset. Once the system enters the band of proportional control, the PI controller periodically tests to determine whether the actual viscosity is above or below the set point. If it is below, the proportional band is very slowly adjusted upward at a rate that is slow compared to the response time of the system. Eventually, the offset is reduced to zero, at which point the system continues to dither above and below the set point by a small amount. If the proportional bandwidth is reduced, the response of the controller will be faster, and, in general, the offset will be smaller. If the proportional band is set too small, the system will oscillate. As a rule of thumb, set the proportional band as small as possible without inducing oscillations. To visualize the oscillation process, imagine that the proportional band is set to zero. With temperature-based control, if the temperature is below the set point, the heat will be on full. Full heat application will continue until the thermal detector reaches the set point temperature. At that point, the heat application will go full off. But by then, the system will be overheated and will overshoot the set point. When the temperature detector cools to the set point, the heat will switch on full. But by then, much of the system will have cooled below the set point. The result is oscillation. Proportional integral derivative control is similar to PI control, except a derivative action increases the reaction time of the control system. The smaller the derivative action, the faster the control system will be within certain limits. The viscosity controller positions the steam valve of the fuel oil heater directly or indirectly by adjusting the set point of a separate slave controller. The slave controller is of the PID type. The feedback signal to the slave controller is the mean tube metal temperature of the fuel oil heaters. The viscosity sensor can be mounted any place between the fuel oil heater and ME inlet by specification of nominal transport time delay. Note that the actual time delay will be adjusted according to fuel oil flow. The delay will increase rapidly at low fuel oil flow and may then cause oscillations. At low load, it may prove necessary to stabilize the control by reducing the steam supply to the fuel oil heaters. Here we have a schematic illustration that shows how the Viscotherm automatic viscosity controller is built into the fuel oil system. A differential pressure transmitter is used, which linearly converts the differential oil pressure to a control air pressure, varying between 3 and 15 psi. This controller air pressure, which varies linearly with the viscosity measured, flows to a central adjustment or control panel. This control system consists of the following main parts: control or adjustment panel, viscosity reader, shut-off valve on the viscotherm sensor, electric motor, fuel line to fuel pump, shut-off valve in fuel bypass line, fine filter, fuel oil preheater, differential pressure transmitter, steam control valve, shut-off valves, valve for manual control, compressed air supply line, combined air filter and pressure reducer, steam supply, fuel oil inlet, outlet for condensate, combined air filter and pressure reducer. The housing contains a stainless steel gear pump, to which a stainless steel capillary tube is connected. The gear pump is driven by an electric motor and continuously draws a constant amount of oil from the chamber and forces it through the capillary tube. As the flow through the capillary tube is laminar, the differential pressure across the capillary tube is directly proportional to the viscosity of the oil. With this viscosity sensor, the differential pressure is transferred to an indicator and the viscosity controller. The indicator scale is graded as required in Redwood seconds or centistokes. A temperature correction scale is provided under the viscosity scale to make the adjustment of the supply of steam, thermal oil or electrical oil preheater easier. Possible pressure pulsations in the fuel line can be dampened by means of the hand-operated valves mounted under the indicator. The viscosity sensor consists furthermore of a housing in which is mounted a capillary tube assembly as the measuring element, together with a gear pump. An electric motor with reduction gear drives the pump in such a way that the volume of oil flowing through the capillary tubes is constant. As the flow through the capillary assembly is laminar, the pressure differential across the capillary is directly proportional to the viscosity of the fuel oil. Each capillary tube assembly consists of a glass measuring capillary in a resilient stainless steel housing, and a stainless steel damping capillary to compensate for undue pressure waves in the fuel lines. The use of a glass capillary reduces the possibility of clogging by cold, heavy fuel oil. A thermometer displays the actual fuel temperature. Two pressure taps are provided to connect the differential pressure developed across the capillaries to the differential pressure transmitter. The plus tap is connected to the measuring capillary, and the minus tap is connected to the damping capillary. A magnetic coupling between viscosity sensor motor and gear pump provides a leak-free power transmission and prevents overloading the electric motor. The viscosity control station receives a 0.2 to 1.0 bar or 3 to 15 psi signal from the differential pressure transmitter and compares this signal with the desired set point viscosity value. Any deviation between the actual viscosity and the desired viscosity results in a corrective air signal to the control valve to control the amount of steam, thermal oil, or electric power to the fuel heater.